Probando, probando.
Testing.
Izquierda.
Left.
Derecha.
Right.
Te saludamos,
Ludwig. Greetings from Ludwig and I of the channel The Audiófilos y Locos. Thanks for being here. I want to tell you something new. I've got some patrons who have these speakers, the Lintons. And they've asked me if I know the speakers, if I listen to them. And I thought, well, I've wanted to for a very long time, but I haven't been able to buy them. And the distributors and Warfter, they don't want to send me anything. Trying to get in touch with them. If you're watching this, Warfter, help us. And of course, these are very popular speakers. Some of our favorite YouTubers have them too, Francisco del Pozo, GR Research, Danny, many other YouTubers have them. But there seems to be an extra interest in this speaker, some extra work that you can do, because some people think that the high frequencies could be more extended, that they could be a little bit more fun in the treble, that it could be more dynamic, more lively. My personal opinion is that I've only really listened to them for about 24 hours since I got them. But up until now, of course, I have them in a terrible place too because they're doing the break-in. And yes, they're not broken in. But what I notice is that this is just the sound that they're selling you. It's a vintage BC3, Spendor, Kev, Sterling broadcasts, you know, those BBC monitor sound. It's a 70s sound. There's nothing wrong with this sound. And I personally would not change the sound because that's the speaker sound that they're looking for. In addition to the image, they want to get the sound. And engineers have made this decision. Of course, there's also limitations to the cost of the product. Based on the target price. But as a matter of fact, the construction is incredible. The craftsmanship is fantastic. They can compete with ATC or Harbeth. I never knew that. It took me by surprise. And I guess we owe that to our Chinese brothers and sisters, because thanks to them, it's possible to build something like this at a price point. But what I would like to say right now is that I wouldn't change them. But I can understand that after a while, and I have said from the beginning in my first videos, is that the hearing is very sophisticated. And eventually, you're going to get tired of the sound. It's not that the product is not good. It's that you're going to be looking for new frontiers, and you're going to want to hear some different subtleties in sound from just being used to the sound of the speakers. And we've seen many good modifications from GR Research and Francisco del Pozo. But some of us are not that adventurous. Some of us are not scientists. And I was just wondering if there was a way that we could maybe find a way to extend the treble or change it without having to be invasive, without having to void your warranty, change drivers, or making a big change that if you change your mind and you want to sell them, you will probably lose your investment. So here's a proposal. It's my Aperion Super Tweeters, which I have reviewed in the past. Now, this is an intermediate model. This is the aluminum Rimon Super Tweeters. They have some high-end ones now. They are dipole. They're AMT. Super tweeters. I want to try those for my quads. Because originally I bought these for my quads, the aluminum ones, but they're not fast enough for my quads. But I think the new AMT super tweeters could be a really good solution to my quads. Not that there's anything wrong with my quads, but super tweeters do something special. And let's see what they do. On these super tweeters, you can modify the crossover points, where they began, and also you can modify the output plus or minus. The crossover points are selectable. And so the idea is that you don't really hear them. It's that just they add a little presence. But if you ever want to go back to the speakers because you changed something in the chain, all you have to do is disconnect the channels. I mean, it could be like you have a tube amp now or some amplifier from the 70s that may have bipolar transistors that may sound a little bit dark. And now you got some high-end Accuphase or something, and it may have some MOSFET output transistors that may have that little chalk on the board sound, a little teasy sound. And so that could change the tonality of your speaker. And so suddenly, now if you have made a permanent change, it's going to be painful to make a decision to revert it. With this, you can always go back. It's like you have a backup. So I'm just doing a little test. The speakers are obviously not in a good place physically, and there's no break-in. But I want to think what, I'm just wondering what you think about this, because it could solve a problem for a lot of people. And if for any reason you don't hear anything, it's because YouTube found out that I'm using this music illegally. And so I highly encourage you to join Patreon at patreon.com/theaudiophilos. And in Patreon, we have a special channel, you know, non-public channel to listen to all of these things without any penalties. I'm using my Rotel A11 and CD11 tribute. And I'm also recording with my Lumix G9 with a professional preamp for the camera. And the three DIO microphones, which I refer to as Ludwig. The music is from the LA Guitar Quartet. This is a Telarc recording. Very good. Great musicians. My intention is not to infringe legally on the copyrights. I hope it doesn't get caught. Also, Bye Bye Blackberry, interpreted by Chi Ayalo. I bought this in Japan once while on tour. Recorded at the Onkyo House. The levels are not too high, just below 80 dB. And you're going to hear interesting things, because in the guitar CD, you'll hear the pizzicato, you'll hear the strumming, you hear the hitting the frets, the nails, the boards of the guitar, and the bass guitar. All those details may or may not be heard differently with the super tweeters. And when you listen to Chie Ayalo, listen to the raspiness in the voice, but also the articulation, the phonetic. It's actually Japanese phonetics are similar to Spanish. So consonants, articles, P's. How do they transmit with or without the super tweeters? Let me know. And of course, these recordings are a joke. Usually, my amateur recordings end up sounding brighter than real life. So this recording should only be taken as pure entertainment, because you can be sure it doesn't sound the same way here. I'm also not going to ruin the aesthetic of the speakers, putting the super tweeters on top of them. There are many ways you can locate super tweeters, in many discrete ways. Some people place them facing up or facing back. My Snell speakers have a tweeter in the back for air retrieval if you put them close to the wall. So only as a test, please don't complain if you're an expert and as a scientist. I'm just going to put them there. It's more discreet. My wife is not going to complain. Maybe somebody comes to your house and you play the stereo and they won't even notice that there are some super tweeters there. And if the music gets caught, I'll see you on Patreon. You might want to close your eyes for this segment.
by the blackbird. Will somebody wait for me? Just breathe so little hips and my body. Boom, bye bye, blackbird. And over he can love and understand me. One heart like the story, a day that don't hurt me. Make my bed that I like, and lie, and lie, and lie, and lay, and lie, and lie, and
Okay, my audiophile friends, give it a like if you really like this, and thank you for subscribing if you haven't done it yet. I'll see you on the next video.